Okay. Alrighty. Hello. How is y'all? How's it going? Okay. Alright, so I'm trying my hardest, y'all. I hope there's no glitches because y'all already know I'll be having technical difficulties. What up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. Please tell me y'all love all the festivities I done did today. Like, there's so much going on right here. Listen, I went all out! I went all out, okay? I've been all out for y'all. I was not playing, okay? I was really out here decorating. I was out here buying stuff. Like, we was not playing. So, my camera's up here, so if I'm looking down here, it's because I'm kind of looking at how everything is going. And I'm also, like, trying to make sure none of this gets messed up. Because, listen, we did the balls. We did the balls. So, this is my 300K live speciale. Now, this is supposed to be, like, a sleepover type of situation. But I realized, like, 7 o'clock is kind of early. But I be trying to be in bed playing my games by, like, 9 o'clock. Like, I don't play no games, y'all. I be on my iPad. So, I'm going to try to reach over real quick and have my comments on the screen. There you go. Oh, I got good ass eyesight. The fact that I can see this. Oh, all right. Let me try to. Oh. I'm trying, y'all. I'm trying. I have not, like, this is like my second time using this, y'all. So I'm trying to make this a little bit bigger. Oh, thank you guys for all the kind comments. You guys are so special. So, yeah, listen. If you guys have not known. You guys already know. If you guys not know, I'm like on this like health situation. So I don't eat like this anymore. So I was like, you know what? I just hit 300K. I'm out here. I've been putting in a lot of work. I've been doing so damn much. I'm gonna get some fucking cupcakes. Cause I deserve it. Okay, I deserve it. I'm gonna get some liquor. Cause I deserve it. Okay. Too bad I'm gonna have to give the rest away. I bought 24 of these. Like, I love ShopRite. For those of y'all in Jersey, y'all know what ShopRite is. ShopRite cupcakes is the bomb. Like, I love me some ShopRite cupcakes. I've loved them since I was a kid. I was like, you know what? I really want some ShopRite cupcakes. So I literally made it my business. I'm trying to make sure there's no icing on me. I really made it my business to specifically go and get ShopRite cupcakes, but I can only get them in 24. Most likely I'm gonna give the rest to my mom and some of my friends. So if any of my friends are watching this, y'all gonna have to come pick these up. Or when I'm in Elizabeth tomorrow, I'll probably drop them off. But yeah, so we're gonna pour up some wine. One of my friends, shout out to you, Izzy. You told me this was good. If it's not, we're gonna have some fucking problems. So if you of age, make sure you crack your glass. You crack your glass with me. If not, you know, make sure you crack your soda. Okay, we went all out. Listen, if y'all think this a lot, watch when I hit 500K. Y'all not gonna be able to stop me. Y'all not gonna be able to. Y'all gonna say, oh no, I need to unsubscribe. Y'all gonna be like, oh no, this is doing too much. What's wrong with her? What? So thank you guys so much for all the kind comments, watching me talk my shit, cursing people out all the time, pissing you off, even though you know y'all come back, because like, come on now, like, okay. Sage? No? And she know what she doing too, looking at me. Like, listen. Y'all know I be saying some real shit. Y'all be hating me, but you come back. Okay, thank you to all the moderators in here. I know I've been falling off. I'm truly gonna try to go live once a week. That's the goal, if not every other week. My next live is most likely gonna be with Troyce on the 12th. We're gonna do a live on Black victimhood. I'm actually gonna set that up very, very soon. And yeah, it's gonna be lit, okay? It's gonna be litty. So yeah, this is gonna be very chill. There's no real topics, you know. Whatever I say most likely might get me canceled. You know how life goes. Am I even cancelable at this point? I feel like everything I say is out of motherfucking pocket. You know, I've had a lot of people come to me and they're like, how the fuck is it that the Mademoiselle can say this and I can't? And I just be like, I don't know, y'all. You let me know. I feel like I feel like I've always been an asshole, you feel me? I feel like I've always talked my shit. And I ain't never cared. Can't nobody say nothing to me. And I don't ever apologize. It's very rare for me to actually genuinely feel bad about something I said. Very rare. So, let me see. This better taste good. Alright. It's mellow. I don't have to kill you. This actually isn't bad. It's sweet, but it actually tastes like real wine at the same time. I kind of wanted like a sweet red type of situation, but okay. For those of you who care, this is the Yellowtail GMB Red Roux. It's actually good. Oh, I'm eating cheese and crackers, y'all. I love cheese and crackers. Like, I can eat this whole thing by myself. But for those of you who don't know, and for those of you who care, I'm actually back on a mood stabilizer, actually, for my bipolar disorder. And the specific one I'm on is Topamax. And it suppresses your appetite like a bitch. Actually, a lot of people actually take it to lose weight. I kid you not, I'm probably not going to eat half of this. This is literally for show. This shit is for the pictures. I didn't even take a picture yet. I should have took a picture of it. I was just trying to get live on time. I was really trying not to, like, be late to the live. That was the whole point. But essentially, yeah, Sage doesn't eat human food at all. Like, trust me, Sage will not eat human food to save her life. She'll look at it, she'll sniff it, but she won't even eat it at all. Yeah, like, listen, it is what it is. So, I know a lot of you guys are probably asking me, like, where are you at with all these situations going on? There's so much going on, and I feel like it's too late. I feel like it's too late, right? I feel like it's too late. Like, Derrick Jackson, I feel like that shit has went through. I feel like the whole situation that's going on with Lil Nas X, that shit has went through. I did film a video about Bad Baby calling out Dr. Phil. I might try to edit that today and have it out tomorrow, but I feel like that shit has went through. And then, I feel like there's something else. This has been so much! I hate coffee, Chelsea. Coffee's disgusting. I hate it. Thank you, Janessa TV. Oh, wow. I'm getting all these notifications. Oh, thank you, Jasmine. Shiba dog shaking his body left to right, surrounded by red hearts. What does that mean? Is that supposed to be emoji? Sky Jackson situation? Oh, yeah. Quavo and Saweetie. I'm going to do Quavo and Saweetie as well. Oh, and then there's James Chop. It's too much going on. It's way too much going on. I forgot about Quavo and Saweetie. Yeah, I saw that. I saw 8 seconds of the elevator video. I was like, I wanted to wait for them to respond, though. I was waiting for Quavo and Saweetie to respond to that whole elevator situation because that should look a mess. And then you got the people talk about some, oh, it might be staged. But my thing is, what's in it for Quavo? You know, we have all those, you know, humiliation rituals and shit. But when you really think about it, what does Quavo gain for this? Like, we all, like, think about Chris Brown, right? Like, Chris Brown got, you know, dragged or whatever for beating Rihanna, but he's still famous. But Chris Brown also benefits from pretty privilege and light skin privilege. So there's that. He's still famous after beating the shit out of a black woman, which is insane. However, Quavo ain't that cute. Quavo not light skin. Quavo not that important. He not he not important in terms of the Migo. So I don't understand. Thank you again for the super chat. And I'm just like, I don't know. If it would be staged, it'd probably just be on Saweetie Singh's part, but it's just I don't know. Oh, Saweetie responded. Oh, I need to go see that. Maybe, I don't know. We going to see. Because I felt like I was going to let all of that sail and just chill. Because it's too much. Quavo is the Beyonce of the Migos. I don't see it. I don't even think he's that important. honestly, all of them are not that important to me now that I think about it. They're not, whatever. Anyhow, so Saweetie said this was in 2020. Was 2020 not like 4 months ago? I don't understand. Anyways, David Dobrik, that's another issue. See, that's for the white people. I left that one alone. That David Dobrik situation, I never watched him. I can't even eat those. I can't eat it. I'm telling y'all, this shit for show. I will eat this cupcake, though. This shit is literally for the show. I'm telling y'all. Like, I really don't see anything. Like, that's for the white people. In terms of David Dobrik, I was like, oh, I never supported that nigga like that. I never cared for him. Oh, you live in London? I might move to London. This tastes so good. You in Jersey, listen. I'm about to fuck around and get these shit away. I love cupcakes. Everybody know I love cupcakes. Sego used to be Beyonce when Migos was popping. I mean, I guess. Honestly, there's so much going on that I'm just like, Then there's the whole situation with Kirk Franklin cursing out his son or whatever. I missed that one. I don't know. I was like, I don't care. I give up. Have you seen the video of the church Derek Jackson and his wife attend? Why does anybody have a... Where's the video? Y'all gonna have to DM that to me. What's wrong with the church? First of all right, let's talk about Derrick Jackson, because I don't think I'm gonna make a video about it. Honestly, let me just tell y'all the honest God truth why I don't think I'll make a video about it. When it comes to relationships, even with the Quavo and Saweetie thing, if you guys ever notice when I drag people, unless the drama or the situation has heavily to do with one person, I try to stay away from relationship marriage type of issues, only because I know usually one person is genuinely hurting from it. And going through a public breakup sucks horribly, and I know it does. So for the most part, most of the time I try to stay out of that, and his wife is definitely going through it. Meanwhile, all her husband want to do is push his little shitty ass book, and I genuinely do feel bad. But on the other hand, sis still over there looking like a hot ass mess, looking all types of dumb, looking all types of ridiculous. And I can't feel that bad. So it's weird. It's like sometimes I want to, but then sometimes it's like I try to leave that alone. Like, I'm still with him. But I will say, of all the situations, when it comes to this, for the first freaking time, I'm shocked. I ain't never been shocked about anything that's ever come out in the media about anybody. I have a very good eye for picking out bullshit. Derek legitimately shocked me, and I'm shook, because I'm like, what the fuck? For the first time, someone actually surpassed my radar. Like, hey, that's just crazy. I was definitely shocked. Definitely shocked about it. I was shocked. That's good. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Bruh, sis looked like she didn't even want to be there. She looked like she was in a Get Out video. Like, come on now. That's a lot. That's a good cupcake. As far as Lil Nas X, you, Fila. Aw. Thank you. Damn, your comment went so fast I couldn't even fucking see it. Yo. This is the thing. Let me finish my points with Derrick Jackson with this trauma and everything that everybody's talking about, right? You know what? Why am I acting like I care? This is the thing, right? When it comes to people being traumatized, going through abusive relationships and all that extra shit, when we know they're being in trauma and we know that something's happening and they're not a child and they're a legitimate adult, dead ass, and they're a legitimate adult, at what point, and I really want someone to answer this question because I need to understand, at what point do we stop making excuses for people staying in toxic relationships? I want to know. Because I am very sympathetic to the fact that people are abusing relationships and it's hard to leave. However, it's absolutely ridiculous to me that I'm supposed to feel bad that someone has been in an abusive, specific, or whatever type of relationship for so long and still stays and knows they're in this relationship. It doesn't make sense to me. Unless they're in chains, in a basement, locked away, got a gun to their head, for real, I genuinely can't feel that bad. Like, a part of me feels bad, but at the same time, it's like, at what point do we say, sis, you gotta go? Because you're still there. And isn't the word grooming for, like, kids, though? I don't know if we can use grooming for adults. I don't know. Someone correct me. I'm not sure. I don't know. But I don't know. I feel like it comes to a point where, like, we got to, you know, what's that thing called? Take accountability for our actions. I'm sorry. She a grown-ass woman. I honestly do feel like she knew what that man was doing. I do. I feel like she knew what she was doing. She knew what he was doing. And she only stayed for the money because that's some good money he was making. And that was it. You know how many friends I have that let they niggas cheat on them because, oh, he's a doctor, he's a lawyer, he's a this, he's a that. Literally just a safe face. Or they in their church. I just be like, whatever, bitch. Don't complain to me about it. Okay, thanks for correcting me, guys. Ooh, thanks for correcting me about the grooming thing. I always thought that was just a children thing. But my thing is, yeah, I'm sorry. I can't feel bad for her. Because she knows. I'm sorry. It's not like she doesn't know. I don't feel that bad. Like, I feel 50% bad and 50%. I feel like she knew. Because it don't sound right. She don't even like she want to be there. And yes, I see that, Crystal. He did cheat on her in college and married her because he thought it was going to fix things. And I think he cheated on her while she was pregnant at that. Like, come on now. You know what? It's just too much. If she doesn't go get some therapy and get out of that, I don't understand what us feeling bad for her is going to do. Like, at that point, what do we suggest we do? That's what I want to know. We all know there's a problem. Clearly, she knows there's a problem. That's the thing I'm not getting here, right? I know people in this situation that don't think it's a problem. For those people, I can't blame them because they don't see that it's a problem. That girl know there's a problem. Nah, bro. That girl, come on. I'm sorry. It doesn't make sense. Like, she knows. She knows. Like, Derek knew what he was doing. She knows what he was doing to her. So at that point, she's allowing it. So how bad can I feel? I don't know. Like, what are we supposed to do about it? Meanwhile, nigga still buying his shitty ass book. She's staying, so if she's happy, I'm happy. I don't know if she needs help per se. I don't know. Does she need help? Who knows? So the next topic I was going to talk about is Lil Nas X, right? So Lil Nas X in his music video, I'm going to tell you this right now. I don't go to church anymore. But I watched that music video. I felt like I need to go to church. I feel like I need to be rebaptized. I felt like I needed some holy water. I feel like I needed every religion on this earth to bring me back from that bullshit. Lil Nas X's video was horrible. Y'all, thank you so much for all the super chats. Hold up. I need to stop eating for this one. I need to take a sip of wine. Troy is like, hey, have you seen Lil Nas X's video? I was like, no. He was like, yeah, people are dragging him. I said, y'all always want to drag somebody, bro. Like, maybe it's just creativity. Maybe it's just little stuff. Maybe it's just, you know, I really thought it was just like opinionated bullshit, because sometimes we be taking it too far. I feel like sometimes we be bored. Sometimes we ain't get paid enough. I don't fucking know. I don't know. Kunya, let me tell y'all the bullshit. I go. My dumb ass go. I type in the video. I click on the video. I started watching it. I said, okay, biblical reference. Every 30 seconds, the video got worse. I'm sitting here like, right there. Oh, hell no. No. I was like, what the fuck? He's sitting here twerking on the devil. This was my face the whole time. I was like, oh, nah. I was like, what in the hell is this bullshit? Like, what did I just watch right now? Like, all this crazy shit. No, it was a mess. Then I saw the sneakers. I said, now, I understand that. Just because you may be into that stuff in terms of Satan worship or whatever doesn't necessarily make you a bad person. I understand that. Whatever. Your beliefs are your beliefs. I also believe that sometimes a lot of us may believe certain things are evil or whatever because that's what we've been indoctrinated to believe. But that ain't feel right. That, I feel like I need to be rebaptized. I feel like I need to go back to church. I felt like I need to listen to some gospel after that shit. Hell no. I was like, nah. And I'm usually very objective, especially when it comes to music. Especially when it comes to music. That, I was like, nope. Never cared for the man anyway. But I'm mad I even watched the video. So I'm done with that. I'm mad I even talked about it. There's probably a demon attached to me now because I talked about it. Making sure there's nothing sitting on my couch and shit. Listen, y'all. That shit made me scared low-key. YouTubers actually bought his shoes. Oh my God. He's a Satanist for real? Oh no, that's too much. Okay. La 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 la. Okay. Okay, yeah, the shoes are sold out. Who the fuck bought them? All right, whatever. That's their business. I'm done. I'm good. I'm good off that. That video was really scary. You know what's really funny? When did I watch that video? After I watched that video, a whole bunch of crazy, stupid shit started happening to me. Did I watch that video after all of this goofy shit? Y'all, I don't think y'all understand. For real, for real. All the bullshit that happened to me this week, yo. Just this, right? This little 300K? A mess. Them little cute little photos you saw? A mess. Mm-mm. Mm. I don't know. It was a lot of weird shit happening to me this week. I ain't gonna lie. Weird shit. Like, oh yeah, buddy, let's talk about that. Let's talk about something that's not in the news, because Jesus Christ. So, let's talk about my saga. Because I'm really upset still. So, some way, somehow, I gained 22,000 subscribers in a month. Thank you guys so very much. So very happy. Love you guys. Lit. I decided I'm going to be festive. I'm going to be a basic bitch. I'm going to do a 300K photo shoot. And you know how I'm going to do it? I'm going to get 300K balloons. You know how every YouTuber has balloon pictures, like the 100K or the 200K, whatever milestone it is, and they have the golden balloons or whatever, right? I take my happy ass to Party City. I look and I said, these just $25. Now, what I did not know is those were the jumbo balloons, not the regular big ones. Why the hell do they sell balloons bigger than the already big ones? Don't know, don't understand. I guess some people want to go hard or go home. Whatever. So I literally go around and I pick these up. When I pick these up, I go to the register and I'm like, question, are these balloons really $25? So, oh no, the regular bigger ones are only $11.99. And I'm like, why is this not marketed? Okay. Can I have 300K in gold balloons? They go, oh, we don't have the K in gold. I'm like, okay. What colors do you have in gold? They got hot pink, rose gold, and blue, like a royal blue color. And I'm like, I don't know if you guys noticed my aesthetic I have going, but green, gold, black. Green, gold, black. Ain't no pink. Ain't no blue. Ain't no rose gold in this bitch. So I said, I don't want that. Are you sure? Did you even look? Because you came back real quick. Like, what's going on? She said, no. I said, okay. I'll take the rose gold. Because that's the closest I could get to gold. Now, what annoyed me is I had already went all the way to downtown Newark, Brick City Stand Up, and I had bought a jacket to put on for my outfit. That green dress that y'all see me wearing in my pictures, I've had that shit for years. I wore it for one event, one time. Never wore it again. I said, I'm going to throw that shit back on. Because ain't nobody seen me in that shit yet. I ain't get to stunt. I ain't get to flex in it yet. So we going to wear it again. We going to wear a little jacket. It's a little nippy. I'm going to buy a little jacket. I had some shoes I wanted to wear. Some way, somehow, can't find the chain. It's like, if y'all seen my Shein haul, I had a Shein haul and I had these clear shoes. Wanted to wear those and it had like a chain anklet. Couldn't find the anklet for the life of me. Where did it go? Don't know. So I was like, you know what? Have other shoes. It's whatever. So now I get these rose gold balloons. For those of you guys who are older and who are in college, pink and green are the colors of a HBCU sorority named Alpha Kappa Alpha, AKA. I did not want to look like I'm a motherfucking AKA. Not that there's something wrong with it, but I don't want to look like I'm affiliated with a sorority that I'm not part of. So I'm like, I can't have a green dress on with pink balloons. Even though it's not the same exact color, like, first of all, it's not my theme. It's not my color, it's not whatever. So I'm like, what the fuck? Now I have to think of a whole nother color. Now I'm annoyed. Now I'm driving. And I go to Dollar Tree because I'm like, all right, maybe I can try to find some more decor, try to figure this out. I go, and there's a Marshalls right next door. I said, great. I have some other things I'm thinking of. I have like this black tutu I've been trying to take a picture in. I said, oh, I could just find a nice little glittery top. Okay, you know, pink balloons. I could just wear something generic. Black and white outfit, pink balloons. Great. Marshalls ain't got shit. Dollar General ain't got shit. Listen, if y'all know nothing about me, this is what y'all need to know. I love Dollar Tree. I go to Dollar Tree like it's nobody's business. I don't give a fuck if I'm a millionaire in life. I'm still gonna go to Dollar Tree like it's nobody's business. I love Dollar Tree. I went into Dollar Tree and I came out with nada, zero, zilch. It was nothing in Dollar Tree. I went to Marshalls. I had nothing. These are two of my favorite stores. I said, there's something wrong. And I'm bipolar. For those of you who are watching this who are bipolar, you already know. That's part of our symptoms. We love to spend money for no reason. I didn't buy shit. I wasn't impressed. I wasn't impressed by nothing in the store. I'm like, wow, I'm wasting gas. I'm wasting money. I'm wasting emotions. I'm mad. I'm annoyed. I'm upset. So, at this point, I'm annoyed for real. This is when shit hit the fan. I get in the car. First of all, I'm on Route 22. Very busy highway. It's like 3 o'clock. Rush hour starting. I can't see because I got 4 balloons in my fucking back seat. Y'all, I try to move the balloons and position them in the way so they're not restricting my view of my back mirror so I can drive like a regular person. Why in the hell? I literally adjust one balloon and this shit just deflates. Y'all see my nails? They're short. They're not long. They're not sharp. I literally move the balloon, this shit deflates. I said, this has to be a goddamn joke. No way. I start wilding. I'm like, this is a joke. Luckily, I was only 5 minutes away. I call Party City. I'm like, hello. I was there less than an hour ago, and one of these balloons just popped. Oh, okay. Just come in. We'll replace it. Sis that. And I know AKAs are not just at HBCUs. I'm very well aware. I went to college, and it wasn't an HBCU. I'm very well aware. Anyways, the point is, I drove all the way back over there. They replaced it. Sis that had, oh. Just to tell you guys, I just said HBCU because that's where it started. And we always have to give reference to where it all started because, you know, people be trying to take credit for our shit. Anyways, I'll go back to fucking, listen, oh yeah, also to let you guys know, I'm going to tell you this right now. I'm a Karen. I don't play about my money. People be taking L's in life. I'm going to tell you this right now. I don't play that shit. I turn on my customer service voice real quick. When I'm not satisfied with my order, I was just there less than an hour ago and my balloon has popped with absolutely no provocation. Can you please replace it? Don't fucking play with me, bitch. So I go over there. Sis that did my goddamn balloons or whatever. She got an attitude. And I'm like, listen, you wanna fight? Listen, when you shift over, you wanna fight? Like, why you got an attitude? Why you got an attitude? Do you want to fight? They replaced the balloon, and if you guys have never got balloons from Party City, they usually give you this little clip. That shit, I don't know how to work that clip. They gonna give me the balloon and expect me to know how to clip that shit back. The fuck you think this is? I'm getting mad. You gave me a faulty balloon. You replaced that balloon. You clipped that shit back together. Y'all, I'm not understanding. How you getting mad? Because your only job was to put helium in a fucking balloon and you ain't do that shit right. I come back to exchange it and you got an attitude. If you want to fight, let me know. Because I don't fight no more. I'm retired. But I got people that can do it. But if you put hands on me first, I got you. Let me know when your shift ends, because I got time today. So essentially, I leave. Now, I wanted to do this photo shoot in an indoor, very public place. If you guys are familiar with Newark, if you're from Newark, you would know. Or you probably wouldn't, because it's very new, and a lot of people don't really know about it unless they're in that area. It's right next to the Nike factory, right where the Whole Foods is. It's like an indoor area. My photographer, Sandhya, didn't want to go in there because she wanted to be stupid. So I was like, oh, she don't want people to say anything, blah, 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 because of COVID, all this extra shit, whatever. So she had this bright idea to do the fucking shoot outdoors. Talk about some, oh, since we have weights, it should hold the balloons down. It didn't hold the balloons down. What do you think happened? The balloons doing the stanky leg. They doing the Harlem shake. They twerking all over the wind. They not staying still. I can't get a fucking shot. Let's rewind a little bit. Y'all probably wondering what happened with my outfit. I came home, tore my closet up, couldn't find shit. Finally settled on a white dress with some gold heels. It was great. Did my makeup. My makeup was the best I've ever done in my life. Mind you, I fucked up on my face numerous times. Some way, somehow, my makeup was lit. My makeup was lit. Someone said the balloons flew away. Honestly, I'd be happier if the balloons flew away. But that's not what happened. Let me tell y'all. So, like I said, balloons doing a stanky leg. They twerking all in the motherfucking air. We spent at least an hour and a half trying to get these balloons to cooperate. I'm telling y'all, the balloons was acting as if I was the police. They was not trying to comply. Okay, they were not trying to comply. They said, fuck you, bitch. They said, my balloon life matters. I am not going to stop playing with you. Like, no, me stop. That's not okay. But no, seriously, they legit were not like, it was a very windy day the day before because it was bad. Like, getting the balloons was horrible. Horrible. Getting them the next day wasn't that bad. But it was still bad wind. So, essentially, we're trying to get the balloons. Eventually, we said, man, listen, I still look good. Let's just get these shots. We could use these pictures for something completely different. We put the balloons in the corner. Away. 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 I'm telling y'all, mind y'all, and I know there's going to be people that try to be slick. Oh, well, you in Newark. Maybe. No. No branch. No crackhead, no drug dealers, no fuck niggas. Nobody touched these balloons. They were away from people, away from civilization. Nobody even breathed on the balloons. All of a sudden, I look to the left and ride that wave. Like, nah, sorry. The jersey in me. I look to the left. Oh, wait. That's my left. I look to the right. Why the K deflating? The K. This right here. The K. The K deflating. Them shits was not, they didn't stop moving at all. The K started to deflate. I said, now me and her are laughing. We think this is funny because it's at this point we're just over it. 5 minutes later, A zero is deflating. Mind you, I already just replaced another zero. The three is the only one holding it down. Three, three, hold it down! Oh my God, thank you very much, Unified. Thank you. 3-3, the only one holding it down. I said so. What type of business is Party City running here? Karen mode activated to the fullest degree, bitch. I went Power Ranger, bitch. Power Karen ho. Because you got me. You got me fucked up. You got... It's been less than 24 fucking hours. Three of my balloons have popped in less than... You must be out of your fuck... I paid $51 for three balloons to pop. Oh, I said, okay. Just hold on, I'm coming home to curse you out. I had time today. So I called them. I said, listen, I don't know what type of business you guys are running here. Because now, I'm not putting on a Karen voice for you guys. Because I need to understand why is it that I have to put on a Karen voice to get anything. But when a black woman gets upset, it's a problem. So at this point, you're going to get regular Ivana. I wasn't disrespectful, but I was very firm and I was very upset. I was like, I don't know what type of business you guys are running here. But I was here less than 24 hours ago. And I was already there twice because I had to get another balloon exchanged. However, two balloons have deflated during my very, very important photo shoot. Do you know who the fuck I am? I was like, no, I didn't say that part. But I was just like, I'm very annoyed. I paid $11.99 per balloon. I didn't even have that. I didn't pay for the hashtag. So I just had $300K. So $11.99 per balloon plus tax. Two of these shits deflated. And they're like, oh, okay, ma'am. Okay, just come in and get an exchange. Okay, just make sure you have the receipt. Okay, thank you. Now, it's funny because my photographer is also my best friend. If you guys know, Sunday, I should be on the channel all the time. And she's sitting there. Y'all, listen, don't worry. I don't play that shit. If you guys are not aware of how YouTube works, all the shit gets written off on my taxes. I don't give a fuck. But, I mean, I do give a fuck, but not that much. Because, like I said, it gets written off on my taxes. So, Sunzia is sitting there, and she's like, wow, I'm surprised. Like, I wouldn't have even called. I said, that's because y'all be too comfortable taking L's. All you gotta do is ask. Okay, let me just tell y'all this right now. Always ask. Always ask. Don't just assume that you gotta take an L. Because, bitch, I took enough L's in my life. So, you thinking it's over? Ah, it's not over. So, as soon as they said receipt, I said, you know, that's funny. I don't remember ever getting a receipt. I go to my house. I start looking for the receipt. I go in my car. I don't see the receipt. I said, oh my God, there's no way I lost this receipt. I go into my drying machine. I washed the pants that I had on the day before, and the receipt was in my back pocket, and the shit was in pieces in my dryer. I said, hey, y'all! That's it! There's no way! I swear, yo, someone saw I was about to hit 300K and they said, whoosh, let's go, baby. They threw some shit at me. There's no way! How is this happening? How? And I'm the type of person, I save all my receipts specifically because I am a YouTuber and I write everything off on my taxes. If I'm this right here, taxes, bitch. The fuck? Tax. I don't know the words. Living la vida, taxes, bitch. Don't play that. Because as YouTubers, we don't pay taxes, y'all. Okay? There's T right there. We don't pay taxes like normal people. We get paid outright. At the end of the year or quarterly, we pay taxes. So we have to keep track of everything that we do so that at the end of the year, we could be like, oh, tax. So I'm sitting here looking through all my receipts like, I got my taxes from this, that, and the third. Why the hell don't I have the taxes for this? I don't care. If I even talked about YouTube and I went to lunch with you, what you think? I'm going to write that whole meal off on my taxes. Y'all got me fucked up. That's a business lunch. Huh. That's a business dinner. That's a So I'm like, how in the hell is it that I don't have this receipt? So when I realized that I washed it, I'm like, this is ridiculous. I got receipts for freaking Dollar Tree, but I don't have a receipt for this. So I'm sitting here, and you damn right, I threw a party for my taxes. Y'all, listen, y'all gotta play it smart. When you see these YouTubers buying all of this stupid shit, they are buying it to flex. But realistically, the flex is good for their taxes. But essentially, anyhow. So I called them back and I said, hey, I just called you guys and I lost the receipt. They were like, oh, that's okay. You could get an exchange. Please keep that in mind. Please keep that in mind. Please keep that in mind while I eat this right here. I'm gonna need a shot of Cavassier. That's the Cavassier. Y'all might be too young to know that song. Some of y'all might be too young. Pascal Voss, yeah. Y'all, I take my happy ass to Party City. Mind you, the nigga that talked to me on the phone was a black man. Okay, it was a black man that picked up the phone. I guess he was the manager. I never seen that man. Right? Luckily, the man was nice. And he was very helpful. And I'm happy he was the one that picked up the phone. Because the people that were picking up the phone the day before, not the most helpful, not the nicest, whatever. And what was more annoying is I called local other Party Cities to try to see if they had the 300K in gold. They didn't have it either. I don't know what type of nonsense Party City's running, man. Your papi's doing welcome. I'm not going back there. They got me fucked up. Manager sees me. And I'm sure he knows he was talking to me. I don't know if he was waiting for me. As soon as I walked in, he saw me. It was hard to miss me. I had two balloons that looked alive and two balloons that looked like they just got shot. That looked like they just went through hell. That looked like, you already know what they look like. He gonna take the balloons and say, oh my God, what did you do to them? What did I do to them? You see, you know what's crazy? I've been so demotivated with YouTube for the past year and some change. I try to do one good thing. I try to be festive. I try to be a basic bitch. Get the balloons and shit. Do a photo shoot. Now these shit's popping on me. I was here twice in 24 hours. Now I'm back again. I try to get my shit. You talking about something? Oh my God. What did you do to them? Gonna get my mom. Suck your mother, in the words of the Jamaicans. Suck your mother. What did I do to them? Absolutely nothing, you bitch. So I still kept it a little bit professional, guys. I didn't say all of that. I was like, nothing. I explained the story to him. I was like, literally, this is my third time here in 24 hours. I'm absolutely genuinely upset. This is absolutely unacceptable. I have no idea what type of sham you guys are running here, but this is unacceptable as all hell. It's ridiculous. These balloons deflated during my photo shoot. We did nothing. Nothing to these balloons. We literally put them in the corner. All of a sudden they deflated. I would assume, I would understand if they were deflating while we were trying to get them to cooperate, but no. They deflated after the fact. So it's just like, so the thing is, this is where I fucked up, but not even, because I still would have had to go back there. I left these, I didn't take these, but I did want to get an exchange. Now listen closely. I didn't take these because I said, oh, I just took the rose gold balloons. My dumb ass should have took these as backup so I could have just did the photo shoot earlier, not waste my day. still would have had to go back to Return of Balloons because, bitch, I don't take no L's. I'm a Karen. You the fuck? I'm a Karen. If I, listen, I'm the type of person, if I don't like my food, take it back and take it off the bill. If the customer service is not good, where is the manager? If the service is not good, tip where? Listen, I don't care. I'm a Karen. Listen, y'all can be mad all you want. I'm not gonna change. I'm the one. My friends be so afraid to do stuff. So afraid. Oh my God, Ivana, don't make a scene. Oh my God, don't say, do you want to pay for it? No, then shut the fuck up and let me handle it. And the thing is, they be acting like I'm about to wild out. I don't even be doing all that extra shit. Literally, all you gotta do is ask. All you gotta do is be like, hi, you know, I really don't like this. And it's not that hard. Now, when they get ignorant, that's when you gotta show them who they messing with. And most of the time, you don't even really have to do that. Most of the time, I really don't even have to tweak. I really don't. Like, you really don't even have to do all that. It's not that hard. Just freaking say that you don't like it. So, keep in mind, $51 for balloons. I get to get an exchange. These were about $5.99 each. So six times one, two, three, four, five is about $30. I have about $20 left. I got this little light board situation. I'm supposed to be in here. It couldn't fit and it looks stupid. So that's why it's over there. I got, oh shit. Damn, I didn't even use it. I'm not about to get it. Anyways, I was trying to rack up $51. Keep that in mind. Because they said, since I did not have a receipt, I could not get a refund. I had to get a motherfucking exchange. So my happy ass sat here and tried to rack up $51 worth of shit. So, of course, I grabbed these and tried to grab other stuff. I get to the register. The lady's looking, she rings my stuff up and she's looking at me like, where's the money? And I'm like, all right, so I gotta go through this again. I said, I'm here for an exchange from balloons. She's like, here, I got an exchange for helium. Hi. I said, she wanna fight. She wanna fight. Like, why do I gotta explain this for you again? Why do I have to explain? Yes, I'm getting an exchange for helium. Because at that point, I had to meet you with your energy. Yes, I'm getting an exchange for helium. She's like, oh, I don't think. I looking stupid. Pressing buttons. I'm like, at this point, I'm hot. Let me tell you, I literally been out all day trying to take pictures that weren't successful. My face is beat. I'm wasting a beat. I'm wasting gas. Sorry for the children in here, but I'm supposed to be getting dick this day. I ain't get it. So I'm mad. I'm mad I gotta drive on Route 22 during traffic. I'm like really upset. So, bruh, I'm like, I literally just spoke to the manager. Now I'm explaining this story to her. What does this bitch say to me? Let me pour a shot. Oh, wow. What did you do to them? I kid y'all not. If somebody asked me what I did to these balloons one more time, Y'all making me miss out on dick. Y'all making me fuck up my photo shoot. Y'all making me waste my makeup. Y'all making me waste my gas. Oh, now y'all trying me, bro. What did I do? What did I do? Got my man rescheduling and shit. Got me wasting his time because y'all don't know how to fucking sell good balloons. Now, that's the thing. I've calmed down a lot. I'm telling you, it's the mood stabilizers. Because if I was not on my medication, I probably would have got locked up. I'm telling y'all right now. Because if anybody in this live has known me, y'all would know I'm very, like, I used to be very, like, bad. Like, I was the definition of a mad black woman. Like, I literally would curse people to fuck out in 2.5. I would go 0 to 1 million real quick. It was not pretty. It was not cute. I'm not proud of it, to be honest, but that's just what it was. My mood was really bad. And essentially, the manager came, figured it all out. Like I said, I told you guys to keep in mind the exchange situation. They ring everything up. They were like, oh, okay, you have $5 left. We can refund it to your card. I thought y'all said I couldn't get a refund. You specifically said I could only get an exchange. Hey, yo. Hey, yo. I literally sat in the store for an hour trying to rack up $51 worth of shit for y'all to give me a $5 refund. And it could have went to my card the whole time. I literally could have just bought this for like $30. Wait. Yeah. I didn't go to school to learn how to count. 6 times 5 is 30. Yeah. I could have got a $20 refund. But now I got two things that I have no idea what I'm going to do with. I was so upset. Luckily, same day, I literally just came home, put my dress on, put on another jacket, and took those pictures. Thank God. Thank God. Those employees are horrible. They're annoying. They don't know what the hell they're doing. And what's really funny is when I came back again, the same girl that blew up my balloons was giving me a mean mug the entire time. And it's like, listen, bitch, I could still meet you after your shift. Because at this point, I could come out of retirement to whoop your ass. Because I didn't like her attitude. Like, y'all know those people that be doing those, like, jobs. And it's like they be trying to be professional, but they got an attitude. Like, when I had asked her to clip my balloons back, like, with the little clip thing, I said thank you. She's like, no problem. I'm like, all right. All right, Becky, I'll pull your bitch ass hair if it's not an extension. Because people like to act like white girls don't get extensions, white girls don't get sew-ins. I was literally at the African shop getting my locks put in braids. No, y'all, I didn't give up on the lock life. I know a lot of people think I did. No. You can get your locks into braids, okay? I was there, and I had to wait for some white girl to get a fucking sew-in. She was getting a fucking sew-in. I would have yanked that bitch's hair because she got some nerve cash and attitude with me. Do I look like a goddamn balloon enthusiast? Does it look like I know how to unclip a clip? Full balloon? And it wasn't a simple clip. I'm telling y'all, it wasn't like a hair clip, nigga. I'm telling you, sis wanted to fight. She wanted to fight. I'm sorry, y'all. So there's that story. I needed to get that off my chest. So, I really love you guys. I was trying to give you guys a vibe. And the letters were the only thing that made it to the freaking live, which is crazy. I did get this little Hollywood action sign, which was really cute, but it doesn't look like it's going to fit out. I'll probably use it eventually because I actually wanted to use it for my Haitian channel setup when I get that done. But, yeah, like, I don't understand. Attitude. Like, the thing is... Thank you, Barbie. Oh, thank you. The barbs love me. That's a shock. I'll be eating. I'm shut up. Anyway. I'll be so mad. I'll be so mad because it's like, I'll be so nice. And I'll be having to drag people. That's the funny part. It's so funny because it's like, do you know I will hurt your feelings? Do you know I can make you not sleep? Do you know I can make you so upset? So upset right now that you will second guess your entire living on this earth? Don't play with me, eh? She tried it. But whatever. Now let's talk about James Charles. The moment we've all been waiting for. So James Charles, if you guys do not know, you know what's funny? I see some of y'all names, and I'm the type of person, I see names and I recognize names and I remember names. Once upon a time, not long ago, I was a I'm sorry. You see, I didn't take my Adderall. I'm supposed to take it twice a day. Sorry. That's what I was going to say. Once upon a time, not long ago, I actually did a live stream about Tati Westbrook coming out crying, bitching about James Charles or whatever being the P word, right? Being a danger to children. That's the best way to say it. Saying that he would, you know, hit on straight men, all this extra shit, right? I said specifically because people were trying to absolve James Charles. People are trying to say, James Charles innocent. They're coming for a little boy. How dare they? They damn near 30. They damn near 30. Which is true. They damn near 30. Like, come on now. They damn near 30. But let's... I don't trust nobody, James Charles. And I said that. Y'all could go back to the goddamn live because I didn't delete it. I didn't delete this live. I said I don't trust nobody, James Charles. Because why is it? Every time I breathe, every time I shit, somebody else is coming out saying that he's being inappropriate to them in DMs and they're underage. Exactly, Sage. Either Sage, exactly. Sage, the uncle, the uncle. Where'd she go? I don't know where she went. She's somewhere. Sage, where you at? All right. See, even Sage agreed. Make it make sense. Why is it every... Y'all, listen. I love to keep up with the T channels only because I love to support fellow YouTubers. Even though I don't even care about a lot of these YouTubers and what goes on in the white YouTube sphere sometimes, I just watch people that actually put in work into their content. Okay? People that actually care about what they're doing. And I watch T Spill. You know, I watch all these little channels. I even watch Hannah Still, even though... I was talking about her and what's her name? I even forgot her name because I don't even watch her anymore because I feel like she was a performative activist. I forgot her name. One of y'all can comment her name. I forgot her name. Completely different name. Completely forgot. But essentially, like, you know, I Hannah, there you go, Smokey Glow. You know, I'd be watching these people because it's so interesting, you know, since I watch, they put work into their content. They actually do the research. They put the time and effort. Sage be watching these videos with me. She know. Y'all. Oh, Angelica. Yeah, I don't watch her anymore. Performative activism as fuck. I don't watch her anymore at all. Let me tell you this right now. James, for those of you guys who don't pay attention to the white YouTube world, for real, James, this has to be like at least the 8th or 9th accusation. And I'm not over-exaggerating. I'm not joking. There's been so many. So many. And the problem is people, like, okay. I feel like, especially, this even goes with the whole bad baby situation with Dr. Phil. which I don't know if I'm going to post that video or not. I don't know. I really don't know. If I post that video, it's probably going to be posted tomorrow. I wanted to see if she was going to respond to Dr. Phil, but it doesn't look like it. Anyways, it goes with the whole situation. Wait, Sage wants food. Oh, shit. I think she does, y'all. Let me feed her. Let me feed her. Coming back. I'll be talking. So, essentially, there's this whole situation where a lot of these, a lot of these YouTubers be doing stuff and reporting on stuff, but things don't always go viral until someone does some cop-out. These people have been coming out for so long, saying all of this stuff, and people just be like, oh, you're a hater, you're this, you're that. It's ridiculous, because the same story happens every time, and James Charles is always in the forefront of, oh, he did this, he said that. It's ridiculous, and it's embarrassing at this point. I personally don't understand how he's allowed to still be famous and have brand deals and stuff with all these accusations. I don't understand it. It's ridiculous. Meanwhile, I say something, I get canceled. Well, not really, but you guys get the point. Like, a black person says something or does something, all of a sudden the world ends. It's absolutely ridiculous at this point. I don't think it's okay that he gets away with so much, and I think that he needs to be held accountable. This is not the first time. It's not the second time. It's not the third time. This is literally numerous times. It happens all the time, and people are coming at me like, oh, there's no proof. There's no this. There's no that. If people are constantly coming out saying the same thing, I think there's grounds and reasons to believe that it just might be true. I don't understand. Like, this happens all the time. it doesn't make sense. James Charles does this all the time. Meanwhile, people are sitting there like, oh, well, it's coming from people that we can't trust. And it's like, people need to understand, just because someone does something wrong, per se, or does something that we don't like, doesn't necessarily absolve them from saying something that's correct, right? So how do I explain this, right? So, for example, people are not believing Bad Baby being abused at that ranch because they're like, oh, well, look at what she's done. Blah, blah, blah. She's a problem child. She's problematic. Blah, blah, blah. That doesn't mean she wasn't abused. Doesn't mean she wasn't abused. Same thing. Trisha Paytas done a whole bunch of problematic shit, but she's been right about the vlogs fraud and David Dobrik. Doesn't mean the bitch ain't shit. Doesn't mean she's still not problematic. It's weird. It's like, just because someone has been problematic doesn't mean that they can't be telling the truth about something. And just because someone has always told the truth about something doesn't mean they're not problematic. You know, just be like, we need to learn to judge people off of individual circumstances instead of, oh, well, look what they did in the past. Like, no. Like, that's not how it should be. That really isn't. Now, in terms of Bad Baby, yeah, I did react to her video. I don't know if I should post it or not. Like, the video is done and everything. I just need to edit it. I just don't know if I should post it because I really thought that she was going to react or say something. Let me see if she's posted anything yet. Let me see, guys. Let me check real quick. Bad Baby, Bad Baby, Bad Baby. Wait, apology. Damn, she was apologizing. But it's not that. All right, let me see. So she hasn't posted. She hasn't posted anything in a week. Oh! Someone posted something 2 days ago. It says Dr. Phil talks about Bad Baby in his verbal range. I'm going to watch that one later. I'm going to see if it's worth it because she hasn't seemed to respond because he did say something in an interview, but it wasn't an apology. She said she wanted an apology. So, like, I feel like people need to understand that, you know, you can't just absolve people from bullshit that they've done. Like, I see a lot of people will sit there
and be like, oh, well, yeah, Trisha Paytas was right. Oh, my God, queen. And it's like, do y'all not forget that she disrespected every single community on this planet? Like, no. We're not about to absolve her from shit. We're not about to absolve Trisha Paytas from shit. Ever. Yeah, I might post it. We'll see. Because why not? I ain't got nothing else to do. After this live. No, it's my game time after this live. Games or editing. What's more important? I don't know. My Sims might be dying. Bad Baby is white. Going on Twitter. Okay. So, let's see. James Charles has an apology? Stop it. When did he post an apology? I didn't know he apologized. Where was I at? See, I've been... Hold up, y'all. Hold up. Now I gotta look it up. James Charles got an apology? Oh, it was posted 6 hours ago. Oh, man. Yeah, I can't react to it on live. I have to make a standard video for this one. Hello, everyone. Oh, no. Oh, damn. 10,000 likes. 10,000 dislikes. My bad. All right. I'm going to save this to my watch later. Wow. I might just film that right after this one, edit it, and then post it tomorrow. What do you guys think? What do you guys think? I actually could do it on live. I've been meaning to try to, like, do a live reaction, but I don't know. I'd have to, like, end this live, then do it, and then, like, clean all of this up. Like, y'all, like, I'm trying. Damn, it's 14 minutes. What the fuck? I already know it's going to be garbage. Why is it a 14-minute apology? Why is... Oh, my God. I don't even need to watch it to know it's going to be garbage. Did we forget... It's a 14. Do I have to explain why a 14-minute apology is bullshit? Do I have to? 14 minutes is way too long for an apology, because if it's 14 minutes, that means you're trying to explain. Explains. Okay, you're trying to explain your life away. That means you're trying to say, oh, this is not what happened. This is not what it is. This means that, da, da, da. Like, no. No, just say, this is the situation at hand. I'm sorry that this happened. It will never happen again. I will try my hardest to change. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. Did we forget what we learned in kindergarten? I'ma actually get off this live at 8:30 so I can actually react to this bullshit. Because I actually really want to see... Oh, man. Nah, bro. Wow. Like, oh, man. So, let's talk about something else before I oh, God. Oh, child. You see, I told y'all I was going to eat none of this shit. This shit for show. Me and my boyfriend about to eat this shit while we watch Netflix tomorrow, to be honest. And we probably barely going to eat this shit. He doesn't like sweets, so this shit's probably going to my mama's. My mom loves her some cookies. I have so many cupcakes, love. I'm going to have to text my friends, like, can y'all please come get some cupcakes? Yeah, let me. I'm going to text them, like, come get some cupcakes, y'all. There's so many. There's so many. I knew I wasn't going to eat these damn cupcakes. Whatever. Yeah, 14 minutes. Like, yeah. Oh, Lord. This is going to be a hot-ass mess. I'm already scared. Jesus Christ. Like, I personally don't understand. Next topic. Next caller. We got 15 minutes. Let's talk about something else. I don't even want to. I'm going to save it for the video. I just like the root cream. I had a very rough, actually, I didn't have a rough day. I had a rough week. Very rough week.
Yes, I saw his video on Bad Baby.
Oh, I can go live on Discord.
I do like Red Velvet. I don't know if you go live on Discord. Why don't I do that? What the fuck? Yeah, next topic. I already kind of talked about Saweetie and Quavo. I kind of already talked about my locks. They're in box braids right now. Yeah, they're in box braids. I got them braided. I got them in July. I can't count. July, August, September, October, November, December, eight, nine. I can't count. Do you speak French? When I have to, but I speak Creole because I'm Haitian, so I speak Creole for the most part. I only speak French to help people. Like, when I'm in New York and they be sitting there, like, trying to ask me where McDonald's is. To be honest, like, I really don't care to speak French. I call it the oppressor's language. I ain't got time. Nicki Minaj and Lil' Kim, what they beefing? Push a cupcake through the screen. Oh, wait. I licked this one. COVID. Sorry, guys. I'm trying. Yeah, we can do a quick little Q&A, guys, for the ending. I know Spice. I like Spice. You asked first. What? Yeah, honestly, you know, okay, you know what's funny? Can I have a little confession? I didn't watch the entire Derrick Jackson video with his wife. I literally skipped to her part because I don't know what she was going to say. I was actually saving the video because I was going to react to it, but then got too late. So now I'm just chilling, because then I saw the video about Tasha K talking to the bitch that he got pregnant, and I thought he was going to respond to that, and he didn't, and then I let it go. I was born in America, for those asking. Oh, child. What is going on? What is Addison Rae beef? Who's Addison Rae again? Someone remind me. How are you? In a way better place. I think I'm finally coming out of my depression that I just realized I was in. Yo, would y'all believe it? That I didn't know I was depressed until January. Wild. So I'm doing way better. I've decided I'm going to start living life. And for the person who asked if I was single, no. I am not single. I got a homie. That's my daddy. I love my baby. TikTok white girl. Why do we care about a TikTok white girl again? Why do we care about these, I am not even about to say that. Culture vulture. Oh, God. Ew. More? Plans for the Haitian channel. I actually want to do more. What is it? I want to do more folklore and mythology type of videos. Like, I want to do videos on, like, dedicated videos on different mythical creatures, like, you know, harpies and lugao and mermaids and Sasquatch and stuff like that. Of course, voodoo, Haitian politics, stuff like that. I really want to do more, like, documentary type style videos, but I need to figure out the style. I actually need to get a logo made, and I actually want to dedicate a nice little corner in my room, but I might move because my lease is up. So I need to decide if I'm moving or not, but I actually got to get my thing made first. So, do you have kids? Hell no. Not that listen, I love kids, but I want to be married before I have kids first. Someone asked what games do I play. My favorite game right now is actually Redecor. Love that game. I actually play Word Life right now. I play a game that I be promoting to you guys. I played a lot, Shadow's Edge. Another game I promote to you guys, Covet Fashion. I play Sims, of course. That's hands down one of my favorite. I have a couple games I haven't played yet that are on my phone, but I don't remember what they're called. They're not even on my phone. I'm lying. My iPad. But, yeah. The Pagan Origins of Easter. All them damn holidays are damn or pagan. All of them. Do you watch anime? Nope. Thanks. You can watch my house tour. I have one. I'm not going to react to his reaction. Study D'Angelo. What am I going to study his videos for? I love his videos, but what am I studying them for? This tastes so good. Do you play Episode? I used to. I actually did videos at one point playing Episode. I think I deleted them. I don't know why. But those videos were so good. Yo, you know what's funny? Any story time plan. Let me tell y'all. I was actually supposed to upload a story time today. This live was supposed to be yesterday or tomorrow. I was supposed to upload a story time today, but I couldn't because I couldn't find receipts for it. And I know you guys would not believe the story time. And I'm so fucking upset because I really want to do the story time. The story time is on the time my stalker broke into my dorm room. It sounds fucking crazy. I'm not from Newark. I live in Newark. I am from Elizabeth, New Jersey. Thank you, Felix. I live in Newark, but I'm from Elizabeth, New Jersey. So, yeah. My stalker broke into my dorm room. Literally had to file a police report. It was a whole hot ass mess. And it wasn't just me. It was me, my friends, my whole college clique. And I can't find the receipts. And I'm the type of person, I used to be the story time queen. Okay, I used to be the receipts queen. And I can't find the receipts for this shit at all. So until I find the receipts, I'm not doing that story time. Because I know you guys would not, okay, would not believe it. So, yeah. The link for my Discord is definitely updated now. It should work now. Let me see if it works now. Because I kind of updated it. I hope it works. Because I kind of updated it. Let me see. Let me see. It should be updated. If it's not, then Discord's playing games. Because I literally made sure I updated it before. Let me make sure I mute this shit before I click on the live. Safari? No, it's not. You need to check the link right here. I don't know what you're doing. But yeah. My stalker broke into my dorm room, stole my shit. Yeah, you can have a regular... I made sure the link is permanent. That specific link is a permanent link. You can set it for permanent. Say, why are you running? Yeah. This is my last cupcake. I listen to all types of compa. I'm going to have to listen to compa to listen to this, little apology that James Charles put out. Because James Charles tripping was a 14-minute apology. So 7 minutes left, y'all. This is good. A good cupcake. I don't accept friend requests on Discord. So, I was supposed to say something. Oh, so I wanted to do lives every week. Twice a week would be with a person. The one on the 12th is going to be with Troyce. It's going to be on Black Victimhood. The one on the 29th is probably going to be on my second channel. It's going to be with Ex-Latina. It's going to be on Haitian versus Dominican beef. I don't know if I'm going to put that on this channel or that channel yet. Not sure. But anyhow, I wanted to do The Mafia Speaks as a live. But I don't know, y'all, because the D-Mafia speaks, y'all be talking about some shit.
And I'd be stressed. I'd just be like, oh no. The shit y'all be talking about, I'd be like, I don't know. Do you believe in the keto diet? Yes, I did it twice. This is a good cupcake. Wow. Yeah, I love Troyce. I talk to Troyce like every day. Man, me and Troyce gotta actually see each other physically. I actually should visit him in LA. But I hate LA. I should. And he gives me an excuse to go somewhere. I'll see if I feel like catching a flight. Yeah, not yet. I couldn't find any good ones. I couldn't find any. Like, these reactions are hard to do, y'all. I would do them just every day, all day. But there's not that many good ones to do. But, yeah. I'm trying to find them damn story time receipts so I can give y'all. Because that story time is scary. A Google form didn't even. I have an email for The Mafia Speaks. People just send their stories. Thank you guys. So yeah, we have 5 minutes left. Why is it only 5 minutes? I felt like we had longer. Nah, bro, I don't think y'all would believe it. The story makes no sense. And the fact that it happened on April Fool's Day, the cops didn't believe us. The school didn't believe us. Nobody believed that our fucking shit got stolen by our stalker. Yo, it was so funny. Like, yo, it was funny because we went to the cops. No, we went to our RA, who's our resident advisor. They were sitting there like, okay, we'll believe you tomorrow after April Fool's Day. They really thought it was a joke. Went to the campus police. They were like, okay, you're joking. And we're like, someone really stole our shit. Why would you joke about this? They were like, okay, go file a police report. They didn't have security cameras in that freshman dorm at all. Yeah, we had a regular college stalker. This was before YouTube was even popping. I had like maybe 70 subscribers. Ain't nobody looking for me. This was because of my hoe ass. Oh, yeah, I don't give a fuck. It was because of my hoe ass friends. That's where I got a fucking stalker from. My hoe ass fucking friends. I use a MacBook, by the way, for those asking. I don't like LA at all. LA's full of fake ass bitches that have no soul. I said what I said. But, yeah. I like New York, I guess, but I don't really like YouTubers in New York either, but I prefer them over LA ones. Yeah, it's, we still don't know who did it. We have a hunch on who did it, but to this day, we still don't know definitively who did it. We got our shit back because the school had insurance, so we had to, like, file a whole thing, y'all. I don't think y'all understand the amount of depression, y'all. Like, we really had a stalker. Like, it's funny now because it's like, what? But, like, back then it wasn't funny. Like, the person literally put us in a group chat and was sitting there talking about some, ha, 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 bitches, we see you in the cat. Oh, look at y'all ugly asses in the laundry room. Ha, 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 that's why your dirty ass friends is some hoe ass bitches. That's why blah, blah, blah is fucking ta, 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 and they call it STD. And the funny thing is, everything they're saying was correct. Everything they're saying was correct. Everything. And mind you, they stole our shit on April Fool's Day. They broke into our dorm room on April Fool's Day. But it wasn't, like, this was like months. I don't remember. When did the stalking start? I feel like the stalking started in like October, November. But they didn't steal our shit till April. Shit was wild, bro. And what made it worse is they wasn't even coming at us, bro. They wasn't even coming.
No, me and my roommate were the ones, they had nothing on. I ain't had no bodies on that campus. We ain't had no bodies. Like, I had no bodies. So, I didn't give a fuck. They were sitting there like, oh, blah, blah, blah is fucking such and such. Blah, blah, blah is has an STD from blah, blah, blah. And I don't give a fuck. I ain't fucking nobody. So, that's your business. My friends are sitting there cursing everyone out, going back and forth with the stalker. But me and my roommate were like, they not talking about us. But we get our shit stolen. This, the only reason I wanted to tell the story is specifically because niggas need to really be careful about who they friends with. Because literally our shit got stolen because of our friends. Like, I love them to death. And, to the, and it's funny because to this day I'm still friends with the same people. But it's like, you need to really be careful because you really be thinking your friends are doing shit or not doing shit and they doing that shit. And it got worse. It got to a point where one of my friends... Ah, y'all, it gets worse. One of my friends was out here partying. Make it make sense. We got a whole stalker. You out here partying. Bitch, you not scared. Bitch, you not scared. What the fuck? Bitch, you not scared. And she got cum in her hair, y'all. Yes, they cammed her hair and cut her hair up. Next thing you know, we all getting text messages to our phones talking about some ha-ha, bitch, we'll do it to you too. Girl, it was literally ridiculous. And I'm like, why are you out partying? Like, we don't got a stalker, you dummy. Like, yo, it was a mess. It was really crazy. And it sounds crazy, but all of this happened. And we had to show the screenshots to the officers. We had to show them to the school police. And it was to the point where people didn't even, like, believe us. And then it was people that were just afraid to hang out with us because they were like, oh my God. And all of this apparently happened because one of my friends was fucking with apparently the stalker's man. That's how all of this happened. She was fucking with the stalker's man and sis was mad. And I'm just sitting here like, and sis had a whole man. So I'm like, why are you fucking with this nigga? Why? He wasn't even cute. I was just sitting there like, so we're going through all of this all because you want to be a dirty ass girl? Like, you want to sit here and fuck somebody, nigga? And we're getting stalked. And that's the funny part. What made no sense is I'm the type of person, I'm very, 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 very particular with my phone number. So I know whoever the hell was doing that shit knew us. I don't play that. I was like, whoever's doing this knows me personally. There's no way. Like, how the hell you steal our shit? Oh, man. It was messy. Yeah. Sis was fucking with somebody nigga. That's why we was going through all of this. She wanted to fuck with somebody nigga. And we got her shit stolen. Meanwhile, she want to go out and party. Like, we don't got a stalker. I said, you know you the star. I said, you know you the star. You know you the star of this, man. You know that you the reason all that. You know you the reason we going through all of this, and you out here going out like, oh child. I was like, I'm done. Yo, them girls was pissing me off. It was a mess. So yeah, this live is over, guys. It's 8:32. I've been live for an hour and a half. It was great. It was fine. I really barely ate any of this shit. You think I'd get a refund for these cupcakes if I ate like 4? Probably not. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys so much. Thank you guys so much. I'm most likely going to post that James Charles apology tomorrow because this shit seems legit shit. If I could get it out tonight, that would be great, but I highly doubt it. Maybe, maybe not. Let's see. But anyhow, thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you guys so much for 300K. 500K is the next milestone because you already know we are taking over the world, okay? World domination, okay? Live for those you lost, okay? Always make sure you say what's on your mind. Because at the end of the day, You gotta say what nobody else is gonna say, because if nobody else is gonna say it and someone needs to hear it, then what the fuck is the point of not saying it, okay? Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you guys so much for being here. I am way too short to reach this laptop. Hopefully I see you guys tomorrow. If not, no, most likely I'm gonna post that video tomorrow, because now I kind of held myself accountable to it. This video will be saved. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, follow me on Instagram for updates just in case I have any technical difficulties, because I sat there and I watched Little Nas X's videos and now I've been having all of these technical difficulties with my life. So just in case the video doesn't go up today or tomorrow, make sure you guys check my Instagram for updates. So thank you guys so much. I love you guys.